Whenever heartburn strikes, get fast relief with Tums. Whenever heartburn strikes, get fast relief with Tums. Whenever heartburn strikes, get fast relief with Tums. Whenever heartburn strikes, get fast relief with Tums.
Can you hear me now? No. Alright, let me see what's up with this thing right here then. I'm gonna go for a test mic. Test run or some shit. I don't fucking know what it is. Honestly.
Whenever heartburn strikes, get
fast relief with Tums. I thought somebody said something to it. Alright, I think we will. No. Alright, let me see what's up with this thing.
I fixed it. I'm good. I'm tweaking. Right. If I did something else, then I probably fucked it up.
I'm testing my test run or some shit. I don't fucking know what it is.
Let me fix the camera though, bro. What's up with this John?
Whenever heartburn strikes,
oh shit, I thought somebody said something to you. Alright, I think we will. No. Alright, let me see what's up with this thing.
I fixed it. I'm good. I'm tweaking. Right. If I did something else, then I probably fucked it up.
I'm testing my test run or some shit. I don't fucking know what it is.
Let me fix the.
Because
that shit is just overlapping each other. I don't know if it's, I don't know why it's not over. I mean,
alright, let me see what's up with this thing.
I fixed it. I'm good. I'm tweaking. Right. If I did something else, then I probably fucked it up.
I'm testing my test run or some shit. I don't fucking know what it is.
Let me fix the. Yeah, it's me just looking at the video and shit. I think that's why it's fucking up and just doing weird. But we're gonna watch some videos and shit. Fuck it. We're gonna listen to music. On some chill shit. On some chill shit. I ain't gonna lie to y'all though. I've been fucking. What's that called, bro? I've been fucking with this joint right here. I don't even know. What is it? I'm gonna put some of the niggas on to my songs that I was listening to. And that shit was like goated. Banger songs, bro. Banger bangers. I will put that, but not right now. I don't know what happened to my songs, actually. Alright, if you like rock and roll, yeah, I'm for you. If you don't, fuck you.
Next guests are one of the great rock and roll bands working today. I'm telling you something, if this song don't drop you, then you're not hooked up right. They are performing a song from their newest album entitled Stain right here. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the very talented Living Color. All right.
Thank you. Alright guys, I'm going to quickly show you guys how I managed to average 220 FPS in Fortnite. This is for my AMD users only. Graphics profile custom, anti-lag enabled, chill disabled, boost disabled, sharp.
I'm Deshaun, I'm 13. I want to get adopted because it will be a fresh start for me and everything, to have a family.
Meet kids like Deshaun and learn how you can be a foster or adoptive parent at AdoptPAKids.org.
Paid for with Pennsylvania taxpayer dollars.
It has taken 6 million years to get to this point. Australopithecus afarensis, or what we've been calling the Lucy evolution. Now, it's definitely not been easy having to learn what it takes to survive in these prehistoric times with creatures literally waiting around every corner. But somehow, we have survived. And we kept going. And after a few generation jumps, and of course, a few elder deaths later, we reached a point where I was about ready to evolve once more into the future. Although, just before I did that, I thought it would be a great idea to make sure I discovered this land from top to bottom. Oh, I think we found it. I see something that looks like an oasis here. Ooh, has that got a cave with it too? Oh, it does. Look at that.
screen print t-shirts.
Jimmy Page, the erudite and soft. Jimmy Page, the erudite and softly spoken lead guitarist of Led Zeppelin, once told a journalist, "I do not worship the devil, but magic does intrigue me. Magic of all kinds. It wasn't for some years until I understood what it was all about." Page, a native to Hounslow, West London, shook the world of rock and roll unlike any other star before him. Broodingly handsome, witty, and with a quirky and exotic taste, Page was a peacock among pheasants. His circle was the most eccentric of the Age of Aquarius. Finger-snapping, hash-smoking, LSD-dropping dandies. Page's circle, however, had a darker side, a side entrenched in mystical Eastern esotericism and ancient magic, the occult. Jimmy Page's peacock.
A lot of people don't ignore magic. They don't even never talk about it. You feel me? Because they don't understand it, or they're talking bullshit about it, or they talking about some real shit. But if you know magic and you really study that shit, bro, it's like it leads to everything, and where it's all a loser. You feel me? Where I'm trying to come from, I'm bad at explaining this shit, bro. But you gotta think about it. Magic. Where did magic come from? Alchemy. Where did alchemy come from? Egypt, Greek. It came from a lot of different places. Mexico. It came from a lot of different. Everybody studied magic. Everybody had some type of ritual. What they was doing. You get what I mean? And I don't want none of y'all niggas to sit there and be like, "Yo, we don't do rituals. We not no fucking cult. We all sit there and pray every time. You feel me? Y'all pray. You feel me? God bless, but y'all never seen the man. You feel me? Himself, or it's like what makes y'all believe it?" And that's so fine. This like it makes me so interested, cause it's like y'all believing in something, and when y'all believe in something, y'all manifest something, which means y'all create something, which means that we are creating something. We are creating a god. We're creating a deity. We're creating something. You get what I mean? And my logic is not the best logic, cause I believe what I want to believe, you feel me? I believe what I think is, like, yo, common sense, you feel me? Everything is common sense, bro. Honestly, bro, you don't got to be smart, you don't got to be dumb, you don't got to do nothing, you feel me? Once you got common sense, you can understand things, you feel me? He lying to me? All right, boom, he lying to me. He's not lying to me? All right, he's not lying to me. I could trust this guy, even though I won't never trust a person again, you feel me? You got to think about shit like that, bro. It's common sense. Everything in this world is common sense.
Walking connected him with many of the legends of rock and roll, from Eric Clapton to the Rolling Stones, both of whom he regularly jammed with as a session guitarist. Page eventually founded Led Zeppelin, the experimental evolution of his former band, the New Yardbirds. Zeppelin, in his own words, came together like magic. First, he found John Paul Jones, the bass guitarist, then Robert Plant, the lead singer, and finally, John Bonham, the drummer. An unholy quaternity reflected by their personal symbols, four sigils. Admittedly, this was an unusual choice of logo for a band. At the time, sigils were little known outside of esoteric circles. A sigil is a symbol used in magic, often the pictorial signature of a demon or other spirit, today most frequently employed in chaos magic. They can be used for blessings, just as they could be used for curses.
It's speculated
that Page's foray into the occult may have had devastating consequences for him and for his bandmates.
We're gonna do research on that cult,
over
bro.
A curious slot of time, luck, accidents,
so
sickness,
cults,
and eventually several deaths, would plague the band members and those close to them.
You feel me? Like,
this is known as the curse of Led Zeppelin.
For this
investigation, we'll take a closer look at the historical facts surrounding these events, and with all due respect for the victims involved, explore the detailed speculations of longtime Zeppelin fans, as well as occult researchers. Some say that Jimmy Page sold his soul, the soul of Robert Plant, and the soul of John Bonham to the devil. To understand the curse of Led Zeppelin in its full mystery, we must go back, long before the era of rock and roll, rewinding nearly six centuries to the infamous alchemist, Johann Georg Faust.
I knew he was all talking about occult mysteries. I knew it. Let's get it. I told y'all niggas,
bro. A pact with the devil, also known.
Think about it, bro. Alright, alchemy. If you ever watch Alchemy of the Brotherhood or anything about alchemy, you feel me? You will learn that if you trade anything to something, you'll get double of it, or you get the same worth. But it's what you want, though. So what I mean by that is, if I get a lot of money, I put more money right there, I'm gonna get the money back and more, double it. You feel me? Basically, as simple as that. And if I look at right now, what do I trade for money in a daily basis? My time. And what my time get me? Money. Which means I'm trading something with something else. Boom. I'm breaking it down to y'all niggas. I don't got the best information, but I know what's the feeling. You feel me? I know if I feel this way, I know I just feel this way, and I know, like, what the fuck. If I'm getting myself in, it's like, yo, this ain't right. Nah, that shit for wacky. Nigga, we all know the truth. We all know the truth. You feel me? We just don't understand it, and we'll never get to understand it because we'll never have that consciousness of being like, yo, oh, now I understand. Nah, we'll never understand because we don't know why God did the things he did. And if you ask God, you won't even comprehend. You feel me? But how would I know? You feel me? I don't know shit. You feel me? You got to think about it like that, bro. We don't know nothing. This world is a mysterious world. I swear to God, I'll be right back. Like I said, this world is a mysterious world. So, that's what I'm saying, is how will we know what's real, what's not? Like, and who do we trust? No one. You don't trust no one. You feel me? You trust yourself and you trust your instinct. You feel me? If you feel like you're doing the wrong, then you obviously probably doing the wrong. You feel me? You wouldn't feel like that. You feel me? If you're not. I mean, if you really feel like that and you're doing something good, then you gotta think about it. Again. It's like this, bro. If I look at it like this, what would I do? And what would you do? We all, like, it's so hard because I got so much shit to talk about. You feel me? And I know nobody's watching me right now, but you feel me? At the same time, I know this, like, it's gonna live forever, and the question is right here. This is gonna be forever. I could just straight look it up on YouTube. Boom. Yo, you can watch my videos, son. My old videos that I used to make on YouTube. You feel me? Oh, shit, that's just scared the shit out of me, bro. I swear to God, bro. What the fuck? I thought that was, like, a big-ass rat or some shit. I don't know. Alright, so, I don't know, I forgot fear of fucking rats, you feel me? I remember having a dream of all these fucking rats, bro, on my body, bro. And I think that dream was reality, bro. I don't think that shit was a dream, bro. I think that shit was real life, bro. And there was one right there in the middle of my chest, bro. I swear to God, bro, that nigga was right here, bro, looking at me. And I'm like, what the fuck? Bro, I swear to God, bro. That's when I was a kid. I was like, what the fuck? I was so fucking scared, bro. I didn't know what the fuck to do. Gotta get some church about though. Once that's thirst. But let's play that video.
As a Faustian bargain is a literary trope as old as time itself. Christian tradition tells that a contract with the devil is a transaction between Satan and a person. Satan delivers worldly goods, which the person exchanges for their soul. History abounds with tales of famed public figures.
I'm about to cut this shit off, but what y'all think about selling yourself? What y'all think about that? And you gotta think about it. And I'm gonna give you a ton of examples, and I'm gonna give you reasons on reason. And what would you do? I know a lot of people will say they won't, but deep down, look at me in my eyes, bro. Look at me in my eyes. After all you've been through, after all you lost, after everything, you will die for the opportunity. You will die for the opportunity that the devil will give you. You feel me? I swear to God, you will die. You feel me? You will die for it. You will sacrifice your whole life for it. And he could give you like that. You feel me? But I don't really believe in selling yourself. I think that's bullshit. I think a lot of people is like overreacted, and now it's like, nah, they don't. They do a whole different thing probably, cause it's like, once we got the information, everybody else got the information. For sure, they know we got the information, which means they gotta contradict that information, which means they gotta give us false information, which means we're gonna think the false information is the leak information, which means we're gonna think like, yo, alright, this is leak. Yo, fucking John Cena got a fucking body suit on. You feel me? Boom. You feel me? Like, nah, bro. Like, I swear to God, bro, look that shit up, bro. You feel me? It's like, I'm not trying to like put a shame on people or nothing, bro. Like, and make people look bad and shit, but bro, it's a lot of stuff going on in this world, bro, and we would never know. You feel me? We will probably never get to see that. You feel me? Because we don't know. And me, our generation, we probably will never know. And I want the next generation on next generation and next generation. When I die, bro, I know I'm going to die, bro. And I'm young, bro, and I'm thinking about it, bro. You feel me? Not thinking about killing myself, but just thinking about, like, I mean, when I die, what happens next? You feel me? Like, where I'm going to be at? Like, I thought about these questions all the time, you feel me? And these questions make me sad, these questions, you know what I mean? Because I don't know if I'm happy with the life I got, you feel me? I don't know, I want to do more, you feel me? It's like a lot of shit, bro. It's like a lot of shit in life, bro, that's gonna, it's gonna atone. And for some reason, I always fucking get off topic, but like, this is a video, like, we just talking, bro. We just talking about life and shit. We talking about a whole lot, a bunch of shit, bro. Watching videos and shit. You feel me? I don't give a fuck. But, yeah, bro. In my life, bro, this is what made me think. That's my cat. Hold on. Let me see my cat. Welcome inside. Nah, I don't want to go outside. Thought about a lot, bro. You feel me? I always be thinking. I'm a thinker. I swear to God, I think of everything. You feel me? If you could think of something right now, bro, I probably already thought of it. You feel me? If you feel this way, bro, if you feel awkward, I already thought about it, and I already know why I'm awkward, and I know why this person is treating me awkward, and I know why we in an awkward situation, cause I already thought about it. Sometimes, bro, your body will go into, like, autopilot, which means, like, you just do it shit automatically. You feel me? You do that shit on a daily basis. You're already used to doing shit on a daily basis. You feel me? You're already doing that thing. If you're not doing it today, then you're going to feel like something went wrong today. I'm looking at Instagram real quick. I want to see something. And I might, giving my little sister a taper. I don't know what the fuck I'm asking for. I know I was about to see some bad shit. I was looking for when my mic is gonna come, cause that shit ain't come yet. Where my mic at? What? Thought that shit wasn't about to come. I was about to say, what the fuck? Alright, let's unpause this.
To have made pacts with the devil. The most famous of these tales is of Johann Georg Faust. The story of Faust begins with a dissatisfied scholar who has exhausted all means of human study in exchange for infinite knowledge and a boundless hedonistic lifestyle. He trades his soul. The story opens with Faust alone in his study, preparing a ritual to conjure a spirit. Therefore, myself to magic I give, he says. When the devil, Mephistopheles, is summoned and agrees to serve Faust, the scholar implores, how must I thy services repay? To which Mephistopheles responds, under signest merely with a drop of blood. Which means, in no uncertain terms, with his soul, Faust accepts. Alas, the deal ends in tragedy. The story is said to have been based upon the real-life German alchemist Johann Georg Faust, who supposedly died in a laboratory explosion after the devil came to collect his soul personally. The devil, or Lucifer, which in Latin means the morning star, was created as the anointed cherub, the most powerful of God's angels. According to the book of Ezekiel, Lucifer had musical instruments built into his very being.
What bag? The bag right there, that was, what kind of bag? Oh, that's over here. Which one you want though, exactly? Pause. My bad, I had a few more catch, y'all. You know how that shit go. Let's back in the video, though.
Stating that, quote, "The workmanship of your timbrels and pipes was prepared for you on the day you were created. And thus, Satan is thought to have been heaven's finest musician. It is because of this that there is an intrinsic, almost natural relationship between the Faustian bargain and music. And many of you may already be aware that deals with the devil are a common trope in nearly every musical genre. In the year 1713, famed Italian composer Giuseppe Tartini dreamt that the devil visited him and promised to serve him in exchange for his soul. In the dream, Tartini accepted and out of curiosity presented the devil with his violin. The great spirit began to play the most beautiful solo Tartini had ever heard. It left him breathless. When he awoke, Tartini frantically attempted to recreate the composition to the best of his recollection. This piece became the Devil's Trill Sonata, a composition noted for its incredibly difficult and technically complex double-stop trills, even though Tartini had only just taken up the violin 3 years prior. He went on to become one of the most influential violinists that ever lived.
Oh, he did do it now.
It is often speculated that Stairway to Heaven, Led Zeppelin's most famous song and often regarded as the most popular rock song of all time, was a product of the devil. Besides the well-known theory that the song played backwards is an audible ode to Satan, Robert Plant once said that the song came to him in a dream, and we must wonder, was it one similar to Tartini's? Dreams aside, we must now fast forward 2 centuries to the genre of music more notorious for Faustian bargains than any other, the blues.
Have you ever wondered what would happen if you actually sat down and talked with missionaries from the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints? Well,
Robert Johnson, who would be a significant influence on Led Zeppelin,
we're gonna save that video. I know that's a banger, though. I know that's a banger. But I don't feel like watching that show. Not right now, though. We're gonna play the game for a little bit. I don't even know if y'all niggas even see me play the game. We're gonna, I can't even switch this shit. I could probably switch it. We gonna stream. I wanna see how I play Fortnite. See if I'm lagging or not. My bad if I'm looking this way. I got a fucking, what's that called? I got another TV right here. So I'm playing like a different game. Assassin's Creed. It's John cracking right now. I ain't gonna lie to y'all. I gotta start playing that hell. Cuz said, why you smoking? Cuz I can, cuz. I smoke dirty. Smoke dirty, birdie. Smoke dirty on stream if I can, if I can't. Nigga, you not my dad, nigga. Are you my dad, nigga? I don't got no dad, nigga. How you gonna tell me to do this and do that, nigga? Don't tell me what to do. He said, I like popping burgers. I get booted off your thing. I couldn't even take my skin, doggy. These niggas didn't let me get the chance. What's up with you, bro? Fried off a dip or some shit.
I'm sorry, bitch.
Yeah, bro.
Boris.
scars.
I'm like my ass up. I gotta change my friends real quick. Hold on, don't kill me, bro.
Come in, bitch.
Chill, bro. I gotta change my friends.
Come in, sir.
Put to 120 friends.
Nice built.
Yes, sir. I'm lagging, cuz. If I die, you ass. Fuck you doing, too? What the fuck, bro? You fried, bro. What's up with cuz, man? This nigga crazy.
Easy.
Hold on. Let me take my shit, yeah.
Chill, bro. Chill, chill. Hi.
Yeah, I can get that real loose. That's crazy.
Hello, sir.
But it taps out, though.
Hello, sir.
What's up?
Careful.
Chat, Nick.
Careful!
Hey, he's a weirdo. He got none. He got none. So would you, bro. This thing. Man, I'm about to be dead, bro.
Oh my god. Easy.
This nigga. Do it again.
Careful.
Nigga, you be careful, nigga. Not this job.
Oh no, you leave.
Sorry, bro. No, you leave. Sorry, bro. Sorry, bro. I don't know why it's like lagging though. I'm gonna try to fix that right now. See if I could fix that right here. So I'm streaming. I could probably fix it right there though.
Thank you.
But right, let me see that. For some reason, bro, I think I changed the I think I changed it to like a I don't fucking know what the fuck I'm saying, but I think I changed it to 7, and it looked way better. Okay, it looked way better. I don't know if I'm looking at it right now, but it looked way better. Not that bad, but I'll let you all build up. Streaming settings so you won't be lagging. Cause my shit is cool, it's just, I don't hear anything on my PC.
Still looks laggy, that's great, and see what your number is higher, the number, because all the settings I will be showing you. Mississippi.